Hi, my name is Thais Gibson, and I'm the co-owner and creator of the Personal Development School. This is your Daily Breakthrough video, and in this video, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about how to inspire a fearful avoidant attachment style to meet your needs in a relationship. So I'm going to cover a little bit about different tactics in a way, but I really want to clarify that these tactics are not like how to manipulate somebody and you know, convince them to meet your needs in a secret form. No, anything that takes away from like our personal sovereignty as human beings creates damage to a relationship long-term. So there's no point in going in any of those different directions. What this video is specifically going to teach you about are the important ways of communicating your needs and clarifying your needs in a form that is translatable or well-received by a fearful avoidant, so that you're taking them into consideration, being mindful of their different communication patterns, as well as a deeper understanding of their needs as well, so we can have a harmonious exchange. Anything outside of this that you find on, you know, dating advice and here's how to manipulate people, anything like that, please be careful with that information because it's not going to create long-term health in a relationship dynamic. So with that being said, I'm going to give you some really cool tips, some interesting different tools into understanding the fearful avoidant and how to communicate needs. And then if you want to do a much deeper dive into all of this stuff, we have really fantastic courses for this that help you get clear on all of what your needs are, help you learn to understand other people's needs according to their subconscious programs and patterns, according to different features that you see and different questions that will help you assess what other people's needs are, not just friends, family members, loved ones, but like even colleagues or people in the workplace. So we've got a tremendous amount of in-depth tools around that, how to communicate your needs, reprogram your fears of expressing needs, reprogram your blocks to receiving your needs. All of those things are under our Discover, Embrace, and Fulfill Your Personal Needs course and our Advanced Needs courses. And you can sign up for the All Access Membership Pass. I will put a link in the description box below if you want to do a deep dive. And honestly, part of feeling fulfilled as a human being is learning what your needs are and how to action them and execute them and communicate them and receive them. And that's part of understanding our self-identity, feeling more confident by doing so. And it's also part of having healthy and thriving relationships, because we need to know what we want from other people in order to communicate it. And it releases ourselves and other people from this unhealthy expectation that people should mind read our needs when we often don't even know what they are. So big game changer in relationships and in life. So by the way, too, there's a money back guarantee. So you can check that all out. You can try it out. And if you're not over the moon with it, you still have a money back guarantee. But I'll put a link to all of that in the box below. So with all of that being said, for a fearful avoidant specifically, a couple things that are so important for fearful avoidance is they want to feel like they are needed. They generally tend to like love contributing, and it makes them feel like, in a sense, a part of like their significance needs are met through knowing that they're helping somebody else, they're contributing to somebody else. But the moment they feel like somebody is advantageous, or they can't trust somebody, then they really go into protection mode. And sometimes they can become very cold and sort of withdrawn from a relationship dynamic because they feel like, oh my gosh, I can't, you know, trust this person, or this person's going to take too much from me, things like that. So if you're needing something from them in a relationship, you want to be mindful that they really value feeling like they are appreciated, that they are needed, but that there's a fairness about how you're talking about your needs. Like if you're always putting a lot of high expectations on a fearful avoidant, it's so tough for them because they already put so many extreme expectations on themselves, especially in the department of relationships. They'll tend to put a lot of like perfectionistic standards about how they show up and how they're there for people and all these different things. So with all of that being said, you want to find this healthy balance about speaking up and sharing your needs, but also letting this person know you're there for them too, you support them as well, and you're there to communicate in a two-way manner. And it's also very important that if you find yourself having a really like harmonious relationship with a fearful avoidant in terms of meeting your needs, you want to be careful of this thing that can happen a lot of the time, which is that fearful avoidants sometimes will give, not express their own needs, and then develop resentment, and then suddenly pull away from a dynamic. And I'll make a whole separate video on that, honestly, because it's a huge thing for FAs. And so what you want to do is let them know that they should communicate their needs too. They should speak up as well, et cetera. Because the more that you do that, the more you're creating this harmonious exchange and the better the relationship will go. And you can lead by example. If you're the one doing this work about needs communication, you can lead by example by showing up, having these conversations, putting this information out there, talking about what you need, asking those same questions of them. And then this creates this really nice like flow between two individuals and a lot of like feeling of support in a relationship between both parties. A couple other things. You also want to be vulnerable about communicating your needs. FAs respond extremely well to vulnerability because it's something that they trust. So if you say, hey, this is what I'm feeling, this is what's going on inside of me, and this is what I'm needing to feel relief, they usually will show up to the nth degree. But if you just say, hey, you need to do this right now, and if you're too demanding or too expectant, that can be quite triggering for an FA and that can cause them to withdraw. So the more you create this like vulnerability, this openness, this sharing, the better that conversation will go as well. And then make sure that you're really clear so it can't be misread. Please make sure if you're communicating needs to an FA that you don't nitpick about, oh, but you did all that stuff, but you didn't do this one thing. Again, they'll just start feeling like you're expectant, like you're trying to take advantage, and they'll pull away. And another thing as well is let them know, hey, like this really means a lot. Thank you. And the more you can share like this depth of connection and emotional availability, around what you're needing, around what you're feeling, the better that whole conversation and all of those points of communication will be. And then I would say the other big thing is that FAs tend to, like to feel like they're appreciated. But they like to feel like they can sort of, I find for FA specifically, fearful avoidants tend to prefer to give a little bit more than they receive. Not too much more, because then it can create resentment, but a little bit more, because this is what keeps a fearful avoidant attachment style individual kind of in this place where they feel like they're safe. Like, oh, if I'm giving a little bit more than I'm receiving, then, you know, I'm still, you know, cared for and I'm not going to be abandoned. And there can be some of those different components at place, which I honestly should also make a separate video about, because all this stuff, there's so much to say about each and where it comes from and why. So you can stay tuned for that video as well. But hopefully this all makes sense. Please let me know any comments you have in the comment section below, any questions you have. And also, I love when you guys share video ideas in there. I always get a team member to go through and sort of collect any cool video ideas. So feel free to share those as well. And then please like, share, and subscribe. I super appreciate it. And thank you guys so much for watching. Have an amazing day, and I will see you in the next video.